Breaking political news just into CNN from Capitol Hill. A controversial, combative House conservative, Republican Congressman Jim Jordan, just confirming to CNN that he is jumping into the race to lead House Republicans. We know that House Speaker Paul Ryan is leaving Congress at the end of this term. The battle underway now to replace him with a new entry. CNN's Sunland Sarfati live up on Capitol Hill. Sunland, this makes it more than a little interesting and perhaps bitter, yes?
It certainly does, John, no doubt about that. Jim Jordan, this is something that has been long speculated about. Would he indeed announce that he was going to run for Speaker of the House should Republicans hold the House after the midterm election? And today he made it known that, yes, he does indeed intend to run for Speaker. I spoke with him a few minutes ago. He said, yes, I will send a note to my colleagues in just a few minutes up here on Capitol Hill making my intentions known. Of course, the fact that it was long speculated, there has been a lot of questions about whether the investigation into OSU, whether that really stunted his rise to potentially go to Speaker, the fact that he has been just embroiled in the last month in this scandal, what he knew, what he didn't know about the serious allegations of sexual assault against the team's doctor at the time coming from former wrestlers while he was an assistant wrestler coach back there in the late 80s, early 90s. So a lot of questions on up here on Capitol Hill in the aftermath of that scandal, whether he indeed would go forward with a push towards speakership. So today, John, he confirmed that yes, indeed, he does. And we know at least one person who he has the support from, Mark Meadows, of course, the chair of the House Freedom Caucus, which he co-founded, saying, yes, I will support him. So in essence, let the games begin up here on Capitol Hill. John.
Interesting new ripple. Always drama and intrigue. Sunland Sarfati with the breaking news. Appreciate that. Let's bring it inside the room. This is very interesting. Not a total surprise, but Jim Jordan, very close to the president. However, the president is also very close to Kevin McCarthy, mm-hmm. who is Paul Ryan's choice to succeed him. We don't know if this is a race for Speaker or if this is going to be a race for House Republican leader or the minority leader. We won't know that until after the midterm elections. But Jim Jordan jumping in, to Sunland's point, the last month he has spent saying, I saw nothing, I didn't see anything, nobody came to me for help regarding his time back in the 1990s when he was the assistant wrestling coach at Ohio State University. Several wrestlers have said there was a doctor at the university who fondled them and did other sexually inappropriate things to them. And they say Jim Jordan knew about it and didn't say anything about it. Listen, this is Jim Jordan in a local TV interview saying it never happened.
It's false. I mean, I never saw, never heard of, never was told about any type of abuse. Conversations in a locker room are a lot different than people coming up talking about abuse. No one ever reported any abuse to me. If they had, I would have dealt with it. And what bothers me the most is the guys that are saying this thing, I know they know the truth. I know they do.
It's obviously with Brett Baer on Fox News. I thought it was an interview back home in Ohio. But to the point where he says, I saw nothing. This is not true. These guys who are saying this now that I did know that I didn't know. This is an ongoing investigation. And yet he has the confidence in the middle of that to say, I'm going to run to lead my fellow House Republicans.
Well, he has given some conflicting answers on this front. And I think that this is not over in terms of him being asked about this and the press, particularly back home, demanding more answers on this and the scandal unfolding. I do think it is really important to emphasize, for people who might not understand it, that this is only a race if the Republicans retain the House, and there's a quite good likelihood that there won't be an opening for Speaker. And in that case, Republicans already have a majority leader. They already have they have a leader, they have a whip. All those people would likely just be frozen in place and there wouldn't be a race at all. So this could all be moot, but it is interesting as a window into the continuing divisions among the House Republicans. You do have to wonder, you know, Paul Ryan came in as sort of a unity speaker who attempted and mostly failed to bring together the Freedom Caucus wing with the sort of silent majority of the Republican caucus. This would be very clearly a leader of the Freedom Caucus, and you have to wonder about the rest of the Republicans, I don't want to say moderate, but the sort of conventional conservative Republicans, if they'd be comfortable with that.
And the question has been, this is the same group that John Boehner finally said, forget it, I'm done, I'm out of here, I just can't deal with this anymore. A lot of people think it's the source of Paul Ryan's frustration as he goes. Even if he doesn't succeed, just doing it causes a divide within the House Republican Conference. And some people will say, why would you do that? Why would you get everybody in a circular firing squad, if you will, or at least looking over their shoulder, when the biggest single dynamic in a midterm election year is to try to have unity and intensity in your party?
Right, absolutely. But a lot of people would also question why the Freedom Caucus and this band of conservatives, which is a very small, relative to the rest of the conference, group that has really driven a lot of what's gone on in the House in the last year and a half, and before that, frankly, but since certainly since President Trump has been in office, would continue to sort of sow the divisions that they have. And I would think the answer is that they think it's been successful for them. They've prevailed on a lot of policy issues, or at least stopped things from happening that they didn't want to happen. Now, in a lot of cases, that has actually deprived President Trump of some wins that he wanted to get on the board, most prominently, I guess you would say, with health care. But the fact that this division is going to continue, and that there's even the possibility that this small group could actually be the one that's in the leadership of the party, whether they're in the minority or the majority next year, is quite profound. I mean, that's going to make a big difference in the way that the House operates.
And if they can't win, do they have a big enough block to influence who wins? If it can't be one of them, if they don't have enough votes among themselves, or they at least have the swing vote, and these leadership tensions will matter when they get to, they have to pass another spending bill. They have a few other things they have to do this year. Jim Jordan entering the race for Speaker. We'll keep an eye on that one.